How you manage your money is, of course, up to you, but having the right people in your corner can make a difference. So what is the difference between a credit union and a bank? Denver 7 consumer reporter Eric Lufer is taking a look at the advantages of both.
Hey there, I teamed up with our partners at Belco on this one. We'll start with the differences between banks and credit unions. Banks are for-profit organizations that are owned by shareholders. Credit unions are not-for-profit cooperatives, which are owned by all of its members. With banks, there are typically no membership fees to join, just have a government-issued ID. It's easier to become a member of a credit union these days with a one-time fee, often between $5 and $25, and a government-issued ID. So, how do you choose? There are several factors to consider. Look at the basic services and access to specialized financial products each provide, including how advanced their online and mobile banking capabilities are. Compare current rates, fees, and incentives, as well as overall benefits, like the number of conveniently located branches, for example. Evaluate the options for doing transactions, whether at a branch, online, over the phone, or even at an ATM. Our partners over at Belco say if you use ATMs frequently, most credit unions don't charge any fees to use them, while many banks do. Finally, it's important to note that both banks and credit unions insure your money. The Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation, FDIC, insures banks. Credit unions are insured by the National Credit Union Share Insurance Fund. Both are backed by the full faith and credit of the United States. To learn more about the differences between banks and credit unions, you can visit belco.org/moneysmarts. I'm Eric Lufer, Denver 7.